So here's the track for Now You See Me. It's at 100 BPM. Let's have a listen to the track. Alright, let's get into it. Now, as you can see, the colors correspond to the different groupings of the different kinds of instrument. The mustard color up here are the synths, and these are the woodwinds, and the hot pink are the brass. The orange is the strings. These are the tuned percussion, and these are the percussion. So let's get into the tracks. How they are organized is that if you look at the brass, for example, all these tracks here, you can see that they're being sent to bus 10. And in bus 10, we have some processing. For example, you can see that it's been sent to bus 4 for the reverb, and there is a compressor as well. So in this case, it's a platinum just to control the levels. And yeah, and same thing for the strings. You can see that the strings are being sent to bus 14. And there we have a channel EQ and a tube EQ. And this is a bit like a pull deck. You can see that for the reverbs, for the strings, instead of sending to one sort of generalized reverb, each one has its own level, so that we could fine-tune sort of like the distance a little bit for each particular track. And you can see that these are the groupings: violins, violas, cello, double bass, and also the full strings to sort of fatten things up. For the woodwinds, you can see that these are also sent to bus 9, and they've got their own reverb as well as some overall reverb as well. And you can see that the percussion is not sent to a bus. Each percussion is kind of goes straight to stereo out. Now let's get to the synthesizers. The starting has this drone kind of sound. And it's a very sort of like Juno kind of classic drone sound. And that's from an ES2. One of my favorite synthesizers. You can find it over here. And in this case, we work from the template of the Cosmic Strings Dark. And what I like to do always is to work from a sort of basic sound and then sort of tweak and shape that sound for the cutoffs, for the envelopes, depending on what I need to do. And from there, I just tweak to get the sound that I want. So in this case, this one sort of sits underneath. So there are a number of these sort of like synthy sounds that are sitting underneath, although you don't really notice them. They're not super forward in the mix. So this synth brass is also another drone. In this case, this one's Alchemy. And it's a pomp synth brass. So a lot of these sounds, these synth sounds are pretty classic sounds, classic analog sounds. And in this case, it's an 80s pop synth brass sound. And it's kind of like this soft drone that's just going on. And underneath that, there's an Alchemy patch, which is under woodwinds, flute noise, and flute delays. And you can see that it's playing this pattern. And then it goes to the other flute noise. So you can see it is flute noise weird, right? Because it's kind of the same sound in Alchemy, but it's treated differently. So there's a little bit more of a tremolo going on. So there's a tremolo, and yeah, so that's what it sort of builds up towards. You know, it starts off with this sort of basic flute noise, and then it goes into this more tremolo type flute noise. And then we have our flutes over here, but let's get to the strings first. So you can see each section has its own sort of different articulations that we picked. And sometimes it's based on how loud we want something. You can see that it's violin one staccato and violin one staccato here. And one thing to note is we didn't go with the sort of typical five parts per section kind of arrangement, like violin one, two, violas, cellos, and double bass. Sometimes to get the sound that you want, especially with a limited palette, we layer stuff just to get a bit more power or to get a bit more organic sounds. So, you know, you're working in the DAW, the digital realm, feel free to sort of create the sound that you want. You don't have to limit yourself to an sort of orchestral pattern. So you can see that this one starts off with the staccato pattern, right? But when you hit this section here, so it's playing a sort of octave, and you can see that this one is mixed lower than this one as well. So, you know, you can have different sections that if you want the staccatos to be a little bit more sort of like buried or softer, you can kind of put them here. And this one is just some, and in this case, this one's louder. It's kind of like the lead line. So, and they're being sent to bus 2, and you can see that it's a space designer. It's a dark concert hall. It's a pretty big one. So under halls, dark concert hall, not too bright, and spacious. And you can see that because it's pretty dark, I EQ'd off the low end of the reverb, or at least the sound before hitting the reverb. And I think that that makes for sort of like a not so muddy sound. So sometimes it's good to just have reverbs on the higher frequencies of the sound rather than just send it to a reverb and be done with. So have a listen to your reverbs and see if the low ends are getting in the way. And then you can see we have a tremolo. Sorry, I'm just going to solo this. So it's a high violin tremolo. And then we go down to the cello spiccatos. You can see the patterns here. So it's a spiccato. Logic spiccatos are pretty forward, and you know, you get quite a bit of power from them. So in this case of this track, it kind of gives it a bit more power. So these two are playing the same pattern just to fatten them up. And then the double bass is off giving the bass line. And then on the second pass, it's doubling. And we have an extra sort of bass pattern, and this is sort of like a chord. So this is obviously not typical of on orchestral arrangement. But you know, when you want to get the power, what I really like is you can, in the DAW, you can add that and get it, the accent. And it really does give that power. So don't be afraid to use extra stuff. Like in this case, I added strings from the orchestral strings, full string staccato. So it's a full strings. The rest of them are using the orchestral strings as well under the different sections. So you can see all here. I like these ones. They're generally pretty useful for this style of aggressive playing. So, you know, don't be afraid to sort of like use more layers. To get the effect that you want. And I think that, you know, it works out better. So that's the strings. And, you know, feel free to go through the project and dissect all the different sections. They all are from the same sort of orchestral library. And what I would suggest as well sometimes is take out the reverb, the bus sense, just to hear how they sound dry. So for example, this violin line, if I took it out, it's just really dry. So most of Logic sounds are pretty dry. And that allows you a lot of sound shaping, but also makes the sounds very forward, like you have a close mic on it. But I think it works out for this song. Now, in terms of the brass, you can see that we start off with just a very subtle brass sound. And I kind of like the French horns in this library. It's under sampler, orchestral brass, French horn. So all the brass is obtained from this orchestral brass section of the library. And the horns are pretty big, and they can be sort of like menacing, like in this case as well. So to give a little like pad underneath. Here. And coupled with that, this, they kind of have this ominous sound, right? So you got your synth first, and then it comes in. And what I like about this arrangement is that the synths sort of add this extra texture on top of everything. You can see that if we play these sections. So you get this kind of like sense of spaciness. And you can see that the woodwinds only come in sort of like when it starts building up. So you got this section here. And it works together with the strings pretty well. Not too much in the way. And then when the melody comes in with the flutes working together, and you can hear that, you know, it's got a bit of this artificial sound when you're hearing each thing by itself. But as a group, what I really like is you can arrange to sort of make it sound organic with all things coming in and out. So you can see that the attention sort of shifts from the strings to the horns to a little bit of this thing. You know, the mix has to be this blend, and you can sort of hear the blend of things. And you can see that in the chorus as well, we have all this full string stuff going on, because it adds this sense of power when it's... And if you don't have that, it just sounds not as strong. Yeah, So, you know, when you need a little bit more power from your string sections and you feel that they're not giving it because of your limited samples, feel free to sort of add layers on top of that. And in this case, you know, the vibraphone and the harps. That's right. Then the next one is a harp, which you can find under orchestral, harp, harp. And it's pretty straightforward. It's playing sort of the same thing as the vibraphone, but in the second section, it gives this little pattern. And you can feel adding a little bit of mystery to it. So, you know, I really like all these extra little sounds. And let's go to the percussion, right? So we use different drum kits treated differently in different sections. So the first drum kit that you hear, sort of like a when the rhythm comes in, is this light drum kit, and you can find it under SoCal Kit. This is a drum kit designer. So SoCal Kit, which you can also select here. And we EQ quite a bit off, like a lot of sort of like the mids, the highs, low, and this is sort of this very distant kind of sound. Let's take out the EQ and have a listen. So it's more in your face here. Let's turn on the EQ. You can see that it's missing some of that closeness. And then there's a compressor, and I tend to like to use Fat Life drums to kind of squeeze everything together. For drums, they sort of give this, it sort of gives this cohesive, punchy sound. And let's remove all the reverbs, right, and have a listen. Just very dry, but I wanted this sense of space, so I added this reverb too, which is the dark reverb that the strings go to. But even then, it's not enough sense of space, so I sent it to bus 8 as well. And it's got this sort of like hall-y type sound, a medium hall. And it's 100% wet. You can see it's sort of like this hall kind of feeling. More of a sense of space. Normally, I wouldn't sort of put a reverb on the whole kit with the kicks and everything, but in this case, it kind of works. So, you know, if it works, it's fine. And you can see that it's panned slightly to the right, because in this case, in the start, in the arrangement, it's sort of sitting as a drum kit in an orchestra. So it's not so forward. And what I like about this track is that as it progresses, it becomes a very forward drum kit. And it's interesting because it sort of moves from this position in the back of the orchestra towards this very forward sounding kit. But let's move on first. As it builds up, you can see that the drum kit is a different kit. Instead of a SoCal kit, it's now a Motown revised kit. And it's going to the same bus. And it's a different sounding kit. So this section here is sort of kind of like the transitional section. And you can see that this part here is sort of the new kit coming in. And that's back to the SoCal kit. And this SoCal kit, it's different because the high EQ is not there. So it's kind of like more present, more forward, and the levels are higher as well. And you can see that it's panned to the left now. It's much bigger, and it doesn't have that string reverb anymore. It's just that hall reverb. So it's just much punchier compared to the first one. So it goes from this kit, right? Quite quiet, and then there's a sort of in-between kit, and then it goes to this big kit. In this transition, you can kind of see the sort of leftness of it coming out. And I find it very interesting that it kind of works. In theory, it doesn't seem like it should work, but it does work. So that's what I really like about it. And then you can hear that this snare here comes from another kit, which is under sampler drums and percussions, a smash kit, right? And smash kit is this, let's see, acoustic drum kits. Oh, it's a kit that's not, it's available, but it's not in here. We can find it under factory drums and percussions. Oh, that's strange. But anyway, the smash kit's here, you can hear it. It is part of the stock Logic sounds. And there's a compressor going on. And it's Fat Life drums again. And you can see it's this really big sound. And it's got its own space designer in line. So this is a drum plate, medium plate reverb drum plate. And you can hear this sort of like, oops. You can hear this biggish sound. And you can see that I just copied the MIDI over and muted everything except for the snare. And you know, there's also a channel EQ just to give it that lift where the character of the snare is. And that gives it that really explosive snare. And also there's an extra kick here. And this one's a really deep kick. Seems like a synth kick, right? Which it is, you know, but it's a body kick under layer kicks, single drums kicks. And this one adds a lot of sort of body to the kick. It kind of works, especially when you have a sub, it kind of works really well. And then you have a tambourine performance as well under performance instruments percussion. So, you know, this one adds that. So that gives that punch to this kit. So when I feel like when you're working in the digital realm, you can do all these interesting things with different kits. And don't be afraid to sort of break the rules of reality if you had real drummers. The thing is, you're not working in with real drummers in that capacity. So feel free to use the flexibility that you have to create more sounds, more interesting sounds. And on the layer here, you have this drums percussion, percussion Latin percussion. It's just a basic triangle pattern just to give that, you know, with the congas as well. A bit of that spy kind of sound, right? And on the second part, you get this shaker and tambourine kind of thing, which you can find under, this is a shaker. You'll find under fin. Yeah, so all the different possibilities, you can drag them in, you can adjust the intensity of what you want. So that's the cool thing. You can actually drag them down here to create a new sort of drummer track. So you have all these different sounds that are layering on top of each other to sort of build everything up. So you can see that there's all these very sort of spy kind of sounds, which I really, really like. So cool, right? And this vibraphone and harp thing is kind of in line as well. Yeah. Yeah, it's just the right kind of sounds. And then you have different layers like this one here. These are the tom sections, and I didn't just use the SoCal Kit one, but just wasn't big enough, you know? And that's the great thing, you can layer all your different things. I went to single drums, toms, acoustic drums, and you can find the tom that you like. And then under African Kit, I added something like that. And then the European Folk Kit, which I really like, it's got some big under world European Folk Kit. It's big booms. So together, they're pretty darn big. Which suits this whole thing because it needs that power. And then you go back to the drums again. And this is sort of like the topper. So all these different instruments create a whole. So for this tutorial, I didn't want to just go into the MIDI of each different section. I want to talk to you about the idea of crafting a singular sound for each section from different things. And what I would advise you to do is solo each section and have a listen to how they sound. And sometimes by themselves, they might not sound great, but you know, when you put them together, you have this cohesive sound. And that's the key to this whole thing. It's to create a cohesive sound that kind of works together. And to give it a bit more extra power, you can see that on the main output, I put a compressor in, which is just your regular compressor. And I use a pretty aggressive one, Studio FET, with the limiter on. Not really a makeup, just 1 dB, and a fairly high threshold just to capture it, and a fairly low ratio just to grab the peak. So you can hear that it's more contained with the compressor on, and also it stops sort of like acts like a limiter as well. So I prefer Logic's compressor to use as a master bus sort of limiter rather than their own limiters, or I really dislike adaptive limiter. Yeah, they just don't sound as great. So if you want, you could use Platinum for this, or you could. That's a smoother, sort of more transparent one, but I wanted a more aggressive limiter, and I think this one works well. So, you know, experiment with that as well. And, you know, I think ultimately is just solo sections. Listen to how they work together. And it's nice to be able to hear different things. Here. And that helps you construct your own tracks as well. So I would highly recommend for you to sort of learn these things, the breakdown, so that when you construct your own tracks, you have your own ability to add synth layers or different sort of like plucked percussion and stuff like that, and just to get the kind of sound that you want. So I hope that helps a lot. So happy creating!